categorize the things that you have. Examples: sauces, spices, oils.
Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. I'm here in Boston visiting my son, and I'm going to help him organize his pantry. Come along.
All right, so we're here in the kitchen, and my son is heating up some water for me for hot tea, and this is stuff we bought at the container store earlier. I just came down from that hallway here into the kitchen, and then this is the pantry that we'll be organizing. I do like that there is a closed door, and so here you can see there's cabinets up top there. I can't reach that right now, but I'll show you what's in. We'll have to take a look what's in there later. So what we did, or what he did, was he measured each shelf, the length and depth and height, and you know, the height in between each shelf. So the challenge with this is obviously limited space, but he's just one person here. And the other challenge is that the shelves are not adjustable. So for me, it's what's important is that you categorize the things that you have. Examples: sauces, spices, oils, like first aid tools or whatever. Is there overstock, toilet paper, paper towels? Here you have small appliances, some paper goods, and like Ziploc and foil and things like that. Tea, and he loves to drink tea, rice, recyclables. So those are the main categories that he has, and then look at how it looks like from here. So we initially got things from the container store, discussed how we would organize, and I'll explain that to you as we start organizing these things. Everything is taken out of the pantry, and we've just laid it across here on the counter, on the stove, and on the floor in this box. So now what we're going to do is we're going to categorize everything. Most of it is kind of sitting where they should. So example, the sauces, the oils, the spices, the baking supplies, food storage containers, and other like tea, foil. We're going to put this in categories. Let me show you so far what we've done. So all the food storage containers, like the Ziplocs, are here. All stuff for like paperware. You have some gloves. And then so we did throw away a couple pieces of paper. And so let's continue. All right, so we're gonna work with this pile here. What I see are some teas. So go ahead and put all the teas in that area. All we're doing is we're sorting. Okay, so go ahead, put all the tea there. And maybe there's other hot drink mixes. If there's like hot cocoa or instant coffee or coffee, beans, grinds, whatever, anything for that you mix into a hot drink, or even cold drinks can be in one area. I see here hot chocolate, that can go there, because that could be one category. And then things for drinks, like, okay, so that's rice. So this we can put with baking. And then he put this here for like a container. So do you want to put like a baking, sort the baking over there? That could be baking powder, baking soda, vanilla, other chocolate chips. Yeah, there, see, there's vanilla. Baking powder. Okay. All right, that's good. Other baking stuff that was there on the floor. So just make sure you put it all in one pile versus some here and some over there. You just want to see everything in one place for that particular category. Obviously, we're working in a small space. I mean, this is all the counter that he has, but that's fine, right? I mean, you could use the floor, there's a dining table over there, whatever flat surface you can use, find it and use it. So the container over there is not his. He has to return it to the neighbor. So we went ahead and put it here in the cabinet. So now here I see pancake mix, some Asian type of sauces, and maybe some spices. So it's up to you. I would separate the spices. So let's see what spices you have there. Salt, pepper, garlic powder, chili flakes. Okay, so more of that. Because in my mind, you can still separate spices from like Asian sauces like this oyster sauce or Japanese curry. Okay, so there's more spices over there. Oh, you have a lot more spices than you think. This is actually something you sprinkle onto rice. So that's actually kind of like food. Okay, and then I see syrup here. We can put the two syrups together. And if there's more, here's some vinegar. I feel like these go together. Oh, there, honey. Okay, this one we're not going to keep. Okay, so let's go into this area. And since we're running out of space, we're gonna go ahead and use the floor. So all the bags that you wanna keep, we're going to put it onto the floor here somewhere. So he really doesn't wanna keep any of them, but we're gonna go ahead and encourage him to keep at least the reusable bags. Like at least you have one big reusable and then these two. The next category I see here are baking utensils. So let's put that all together. So now you guys, sometimes you come up with a pile like this and it looks overwhelming. Don't be overwhelmed. Okay. Just pick one piece at a time. So here, what is this? This is a cutting glove. So I might want to put that in a category all by itself, because at this point, I'm not sure how we're going to store that. There's no drawers in this place and you see the knife is there. So, we're going to figure that out, but separate it, you know, don't put it here, right? That doesn't go. So put it in its own separate pile. Okay, here I see some, let's say tape. Are there any other tapes, rolls of tape that you can take out from this pile? Make that a separate one, maybe with like utility stuff. A power strip, good. So while you're getting down to the pile, I see more baking stuff, so that goes there. Okay, so that's an apron. All right, so that could, I mean, the apron could go with something like this, or it can be its own separate pile too. I see, that's exactly what I was gonna say. Put those in one pile, the lighters. Scissors, a knife, okay, pen. So I would say that these don't go in the pantry unless you absolutely have no other storage. These with the letter opener, the scissors, those would go with office. Okay, you have some more tools here. It does have a toolbox. Okay, so light bulbs. Okay, there. See some more, a grater, more baking. Coins, see? See how you just go one by one and they start becoming parts of larger categories. It all works out. Okay. Yeah, utility knife. Okay, that one. Okay, and then the wild rice would go with the other rice. That's there on the floor. These are what? Oh, okay, then this one, this bag. Where would that go? Maybe it could be its own category for now. And then these are liners for the pots, right? That's its own category. And then canned goods is its own category. And also the crackers. What we could do with this is put the crackers, the cashews, and this canned good as food, because you can see over here, it's more of the spices, the tea, and the sauces. Okay, so that's categorized. And the first aid kit, you wanna put this in its own category. okay there on the floor.
This is great. If you have boxes, that helps to help you sort, because it is a physical space that you know you need to put things in there that are the same. So these look like more sauces. So let's go through that. Yeah, so we have sauces here, and here, this is olive oil, olive oil. So for me, oils are separate. Okay, yeah, this is good. And all those other sauces would come together in here, right? Do you wanna get those? So he got the sauces that were in, on the counter earlier, and we're gonna go ahead and put them in here. So you see how that makes sense? Okay. If it doesn't make sense to you, then don't do this. You know, if it doesn't make sense that this chili sauce doesn't go here, then make it its own category. Right, so we decided to put the keep the rice on the floor there, but to get this dispenser on from Amazon. And it has rubber feet at the bottom so it doesn't move. And then you just press this button and it dispenses the rice into here. So since he doesn't have a cup for the rice, this is perfect, because when the rice goes in there, you can put it straight into the rice cooker. And then there's a little bit of a see-through here so you can see how much rice is left. And this does have a place where you could put, I think it's like cloves or something to keep the rice fresh. And this one also, it's hard to see, but it tells you, has numbers on it, so you can say when you had put the rice in here, kind of like a date. So we're gonna pour the rice in and then put it in the pantry. Okay, so then we're gonna sort through these bins, and anything that has to do like paper plates and forks, it's gonna go into the small buffet cabinet and not in the pantry. Okay, so he's sorting through the third bin. This one will have all of the food storage stuff like parchment paper, foil, saran wrap, and Ziploc. This is parchment paper for, I think the baking pans, but it's like more for baking. And then this is, someone just gave him this. So I think for now we're gonna keep these here. And then if later he wants to get more like smaller bins, example, for all his coins, because it's for the laundry, for the pens, batteries, and lighters, he could sort this out even more. But for this is good enough. This is basically utility. Because you can see from this kitchen, there is not one drawer. And so this is a solution, is to get a open bin like this. Okay, we found contact paper at Target. I cut it down to size, and now we're gonna put it on the shelves. I put some of the contact paper on a few of the shelves. So this one's done, that was only one cut. This one was one whole depth of the roll, and I have to add the piece in the back. But look how much it looks better just with the contact paper. That one obviously doesn't have. This one has, right? It looks much better, and it's gonna be easier for you to clean. So this is without the back finished yet. And then this is with the back finished. This brand, Joseph, is from the Container Store. So it's an expandable utensil holder. So it opens that way, and then it opens this way. So what we did was just have my son decide which one he liked, see if that fits. And it does. So we decided to do this versus having drawers. So he's just gonna have this. The other option is you can have a riser,
and then put the silverware on top or at the bottom, just depending if you want, if you need more space on the shelf. And then for the utensils, to just use this shelf where it's easy to get into, because this is something that will be used on the daily, and just having it, you know, kind of open and you can reach in there easily. This is the organizer that is working well so far. Let me show you up here. Lots of space up here still. So I set it up this way just to show that there's actually one more large basket that will fit in here. So back here it has like the liners and light bulbs. You can also put extra trash bags in there. This is for paper towels, and if he wants to get, like, example, extra toilet paper, it can go in here. He has some rolls already underneath the bathroom sink, but the space there is limited, so you could put overstock here. So anything like paper products and things that you're not going to use often, you could put it up here. And then behind the door, you know, when this closes, there's a lot of space here. You could put an over-the-shoe holder if you need more stuff. So he doesn't need more things. He's good. And luckily, there's already a hole in the door, but you can always use the command strip, command hooks, right? And you can hang something like this, like the tote bag and also the apron. All right, then I just put the strap in itself so that it won't be all hanging onto the floor. Okay, so we're just going to take, this is the utility box, and of course it's an option if you want to label it or not. So we'll have the utility there, and then this is used more often than the other two, so we'll go ahead and put that one there in the middle, and on the far right. That stuff, and then there is one more tote that could fit in there, but for now that is good. This is the silverware drawer for now, and I bought him this. It's an egg yolk separator because he needed one. I also got, he didn't have a can opener, got that, but pretty much he has everything he uses, you know, for cooking. There's one pair of chopsticks if you wanted to get maybe three more to make it four. You can see that there's still space there. And there is space for one more thing here. And in the back, I think this is fantastic. I actually like this. My hand mixer broke a long time ago. But see, these are things that you think about there. You know, sometimes they come in its own container. But look at this. It holds its own attachments. And it's pretty slim, so that's space saving. So when you get even little appliances like this and you have a small space, think about, look at that. You know, don't just, if he had this and then the extra wires, they'd have to go somewhere in here. But since it's has its own container, that works perfectly. Okay, my son is genius. So he's going to keep some of these Target reusable bags. Hey, we went to Target and they use reusable bags here. They don't do that in Phoenix. So anyway, keeping three plus this smaller size, and he suggested to put these bags into here. Okay, so there are different options in where to put these reusable bags. Again, you could get a command hook and put it here on the door. We can move this bag of rice behind, okay, and then put it here. If you need some floor space, you could get a command hook and put it here. You could put it in the back. I mean, there's a lot of space. Or we can put it here in this spot. Okay. So he decided he wants it on the floor there. I think that's great. Another thing, option that he has is that he can have a box or a basket here for recycling, because they do recycle over here. And then he would just have to move that bag a little bit. Like I said, either on the wall, on the hook, on the door, or over here. Or move the rice container over there more, and he'd have a little bit more space. Okay, now we're gonna work on this Lazy Susan. I love this Lazy Susan. I have one at home. It's from the Home Edit brand I designed from the Container Store. It's very smooth. These dividers here can be taken out so that things would fit the way you want them to. But these are going to hold the sauces and oils. And as far as the spices, we ordered spice bottles for him to use this thing. It's arriving tomorrow, but I'm leaving tomorrow, so I might do my own separate video because I've been thinking about changing up my spice organization. It's just kind of been hard to reach in, but look at this. You pull this and out like that, right? So anything in the pantry that is like salt, pepper, garlic powder, all those things, they're all gonna come over here. And look how perfectly the rice cooker fits there too. When you're organizing, once in a while there's some random thing that's left there. Well, this is not random. He uses this, these, they're pot holders. So I thought, look, a perfect place to put these is right here. And whether he wants a container or not, that would work. It's up to him, but he uses it often. So he may, depending on what you like, you may or may not want that in a bin because it's easier to access. But for others, you don't want it like these are, you know, all these the same bins, and then all of a sudden there's no bin there, right? Sometimes aesthetically, you kind of want there to be a bin. So here's the progress so far. Everything was cluttered over here, but now it's clear again because we've organized that part. This has to be returned to the neighbor, so leave it out so it's a visual cue to give that back. Okay, we're in the middle of organizing, so you can see we still have these two shelves to do. That one's done, this is done, this is done, this is done, this is done. So you can see we're making progress. Well, this works out that there's two of us, but if there's only one of you, you know, just take a little bit more effort. So what he's doing is he's emptying it, putting it here, and while it's going here, I'm going to categorize and sort it. Okay, so we're having a dilemma here because we don't know everything that's there and kind of how much space it will take. So what we'll do is we're gonna take everything out. As you can see, I've moved the Lazy Susan over to the right. So there's space here. It could actually fit one of these bins if he wants to put all the tea there, or if he wants a tea stand, a tea organizer there. And then this pot holder can also go into this bin and there'd be more space here. Let's say for like snacks or canned goods. So we just gotta work with it. Okay, right now he has a bowl on top of his fridge for fruit. So he might need another bowl to put like onions and garlic, things like that. So I'll put that there for now. For like vegetables like that, you get like a wire basket and it could sit in here because there's more space up there. And these are pretty to display. These are from Target, so olive oil, V here for vinegar, salt and pepper. Okay, so now it's empty. So what I do from here is I put in the things I know for sure I want to go in there. So for sure we want the sauces and the oils and the vinegars to go in here. So we'll do that for now. All right, so I highly suggest to get a short bin here or even this bin, okay? That's up to him, but you can see here the Lazy Susan. I'm telling you, this is a great solution for many organizing issues in the kitchen. Look at that. So what we did was we did oil, vinegar, sauces, and like pancake mix or like liquid baking stuff. Above the stove, he keeps his electric kettle there. So we decided let's just put the tea stuff here and he can reach it. This plug cannot be pushed in more. So since it does like a natural circle, we have the plate here for the electric kettle to just sit in that, and he just has to separate the tea. But he can always measure up and down the depth, the width, if there's some type of organizer he wants to put in there or even in here. But for now, the boxes work. Up here, he had his placemats and they kind of hung over. So since there's space here now on the top shelf, he put his placemats there and then the baking is here. Same thing with the baking. If he wants a bin or a basket and, you know, tidy it up more, he can do that. But the thing is that it is organized because it's a system. He knows that this is the baking zone, this is the sauces zone, oil and vinegar, the utensils and cooking utensils there, more utility stuff and the food storage containers and the rice, the bag, apron and tote over there. And then these spices he will have to take care of. Like I said earlier, put them into the nice spice holders with the labels that he got and put it into that spice rack. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed this video of how we organize his small pantry in his apartment. Click the next one for more organizing, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.